Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Alright, in this tutorial we're going to look what happens when we scale something up nice and big, okay, and it rushes towards the screen and it gets all pixelated. Okay, and we're going to show you how to make it like this, all vector and clean. And basically we just turn that button on. But let's do it into a little tutorial. But seriously, it's just turning that button on. Okay, so we're going to do this with a little example file. So we're going to go to a new composition. Okay, we're going to call this one Vector Redraw. Okay, and we're gonna leave it all like this, 5 seconds. We're gonna change the background color to, we're gonna click on it, change it to white. Okay, just to save time, we should put a solid in because what's gonna happen if we change the background color to white, when it exports, gonna go black. Okay, so we're just cheating now. Okay, so vector redraw, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click. Remember that's the shortcut to import. We're gonna bring in the bring your own laptop logo. Okay, there it is there. I'll put it in my files folder. Same with these offset guys, get in there. Okay, and in here, bring your own laptop, bring it in. Okay, so that's cool, and I wanna scale it up. Okay, so what I'll do is up here, I'm gonna hit S for scale, set the timer going. Okay, and when it gets bigger, maybe about half a second, okay, I'd like to scale it right up. So it's gonna go kind of like it's flying towards the camera. I don't know why I do the sound effects. It doesn't help really. But the problem is, can you see? A, it's ugly because we haven't had easing yet, but you see when it gets really close to the screen, okay, it has pixelated, it looks really crappy. It's vector, so it should be fine. All you need to do when this happens is this little checkbox here. Okay, see this little sparkle? You can see there it says continuously rasterize. So it's gonna redraw it every time on every frame. Okay, why wouldn't that be on by default? It's quite system demanding. Okay, so if you've got lots of vector shapes all flying around and there's no need to redraw them every single time, it doesn't, unless you force it to by clicking this little gap in here and it goes nicely. Okay, a couple of things we're gonna do to finish this off. You can skip now. We're just gonna sex it up a little bit, I guess, and practice our use of the graph editor. Okay, so and what I'm gonna do is maybe just apply easing to both sides of this. I like to apply ease even if I'm gonna use the graph editor, because what happens is once you jump into the graph editor now, got them both selected, it kind of gives you some handles to work with. If you don't, and I undo, it's just a flat line and you've gotta click on these points and then go in here and say, I'd like to create an easy ease on this one. And easy ease in this, and that's fine. Okay, do it either side, I don't mind. Now the cool thing about this is that because we're only doing one thing, okay, these guys are tied together, we don't have to split them. Remember in an earlier tutorial we had to split the X and Y, which is down there, okay, but it's grayed out at the moment because these guys don't need splitting. And all we want to do is play around with these handles, and when it becomes to like, so what we've done up until now, we've kind of made it slow at the start and the beginning and fast in the middle. What I'd like to do is this case is I want it to be slow at the beginning. Okay, and go slow, go slow, go slow. And as it goes along, it's gonna get faster and faster. Okay, so let's have a look at this now. I'm gonna bring my playhead here. So it just kind of starts and then gets faster as it comes towards you. Is it brilliant? I'm not liking it at the moment. Play around with it. That's getting better. Okay, go back to the graph editor. It's kind of doing what I want. Yeah, let's try that. Now I'm just messing about. Yeah, it's cool. Turn the motion blur on, okay, for up there, turn it down here. So when it starts really moving, okay, it starts doing the whole blurring motion, but it's actually nice blur rather than just pixelating. Okay, and there's a lot of time where it's down here where it's actually redrawn nicely as well. All right, so that is vector redrawing, making sure that your graphics, any graphics from Illustrator, don't become blurry when they get scaled. Hey there, what'd you think? If you like the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.